Game two last night, a back and forth thriller. Chicago's Courtney Vandersloot tied it up with 4 seconds remaining in regulation. That forced a little OT, and then Diana Taurasi did what she likes to do best. She would take over. In fact, DT outscored the Sky 8-7 by herself, by the way, in overtime. It marked the third time in WNBA Finals history a player outscored the entire opposing team in overtime, and Mercury went on to win.
She didn't do it alone. The winner here is OMBG. Oh, my Brittany Griner. Get up like Greeny. That was her sixth dunk of the season, the first in WNBA Finals history. Griner dominant. 12 of 19 for 29 points, leading all scores, tying this series up at one game apiece, and heads back to the Windy City.
All right, that's the winner. How about a loser? Ankles would be the loser here. Speaking of the Mercury's dominance, Phoenix's Sophie Cunningham returned to the lineup last night after missing 3 games. And check out what she does. She just, you know, breaking ankles in no time. Not to mention she was also burying threes every other second. All right. Way to return, Miss Cunningham.
The winner here, Vander Slick. Courtney Vandersloot, her fourth 10-plus assist game this postseason, the most in a single postseason in the league's history. She also went for 20 points. The Solis Sky team did her job, but it wasn't enough in a losing effort. Also, shout out to married couples making it work professionally, Her Sky teammate and spouse, sharpshooting Allie Quigley, went for 19, but of course, Sky lost this one.
Sky did lose this one, but so now this series is tied up at one apiece since the Mercury won last night in OT, and I think, you know, at least you and I yesterday, when we were having a discussion about the WNBA Finals, we thought it was Chicago's to run away with based on the way they played in game one. But after last night's performance, now it's a series.
Well, it was impressive to me to watch Allie Quigley defensively and what she was able to do against Diana Taurasi, just hounding her for the better part of that game. Taurasi played like a goat, though, down the stretch, making that three and the foul in overtime, another crucial three in that overtime. But Brittany Griner, and when talking with Monica McNutt a day ago, leading into that one, she said Brittany Griner has to be special. She has to be dominant. She absolutely was that. That was the difference. What kind of adjustments defensively do the Sky make going into this next one? Because there was no answer for Griner.
Speaking of defensive moves, Brittany Griner did it on offense and on defense. She was special last night defensively. All right, so he said a lot of things there. There's levels to it, as Kendrick Lamar likes to say, right? And I'm going to start things off with what I heard first in Kyrie Irving, and I know you criticize me for doing this sometimes. But nonetheless, look, I think in this situation, it doesn't just affect him. It affects the team as a whole, and he needs to make a decision for himself. Look, in our household, we made the decision for us on what we wanted to do, and everyone needs to do that going forward. But this isn't just about him now. It's about other people. And so when he says, you know, you got to come to me, you got to come to the source, use logic. Well, dude, this is the first time you're talking to us, and it's through IG Live. If you had something to say as to a reason why you weren't getting vaccinated or how this all came about and why there are all these narratives that have been created, it's your job to tell us that. So all these different stories that have been coming out is because you didn't come to us sooner with what your situation was. And so I just think it's unfair for him to point fingers at the media and other people and say, like, you guys are saying this, use logic, use that. You're just now coming to the forefront with what you feel. I respect his decision. That's fine. You got to do what's best for you. But it also affects everyone around you, and so people are going to have questions about it.
Yeah, and for one, I hated the timing of this IG Live because Kyrie's been a big proponent of pushing the platform of WNBA, and yet still he chose to go out there and make his voice heard in the middle of what was an incredible WNBA Finals game, that game two, which ultimately went to the Mercury. And meanwhile, he's talking about this finally at that point. In all honesty, though, this is the most relatable, I think, Kyrie sounded. Some of these half-baked ideas where he wants to be the face of a movement and you're kind of sitting there scratching your head and going, well, how is this helping as opposed to being more of a distraction? In this moment, I think he speaks for a lot of people out there, ones I don't agree with, but I still respect their opinion. Is there's some trepidation as it pertains to getting the vaccine, and here's why he feels that way, and he feels like he shouldn't have a mob coming after him. Mm-hmm. I know people in my life that feel that way. I don't agree with them, but I think he speaks for maybe it's a majority, maybe it's a minority, and for reasons we might not agree with, you still have to respect that Kyrie doesn't want to be one of those people. I actually do believe he feels uncomfortable in this moment, in this circumstance, where everybody's putting this on him and he feels like there's a mob mentality coming at him. They have a reason for coming at him, but you see a lot of cases like Kyrie's, and I don't think he should be ostracized for that.
I agree with you. I also find it very interesting that he hasn't communicated this either with his team or with management, or at least they haven't come forward and said that, because how can they support him if they don't know his reasoning? And us learning, I think that's a great point.
He should have gotten in front of it. He should have gotten in front of it.
And that's it. He wasn't proactive about it. And maybe he didn't see the mandates coming. But nonetheless, I think all of us have to anticipate the next move given what we've gone through in the last 2 years.
And quite frankly, he does still become a distraction to his team, fair or not, and they need to make a real decision. They started to by saying you're either all in or you're out, but this hasn't been fully resolved, and they're going to need it to because this team has championship on the mind.
Mm-hmm, for sure. Speaking of the association and what's going on in the NBA and perhaps champions, let's start with the defending champions. That would be the Milwaukee Bucks facing off with the Utah Jazz last night. And this is a nice little, what would you call it, Jay?
Batman. Batman and Robin, no question. Middleton and delivering that thing to Giannis, that's the secret sauce for this Bucks team. When those two playing at a high level with chemistry, they could be the front runner in the East.
Celtics facing off with the Magic, and Mo Bamba had himself a night. Not one, not two, not three, not four, five blocks. And what are we saying?
No, not today. I'm getting a lot of voiceover work. But it's fun watching a guy in his element, understanding what his role is and mastering it. A healthy Mo Bamba, give me that.
He had four blocks, actually, in total. Pistons visiting the Knicks. And that is OB.
Top in. Look, if this guy can realize the talent, figure it out at this next level, as he's expected to do there in the bright lights, if the city that doesn't sleep doesn't slip him an Ambien, watch out for this group.
See what you did there. Hornets hosting the Mavs. And this was a delight for one team and one team only. And we're laughing because why?
The final LOL savage tweet from the Mavs victorious in this one. And look, sometimes you're the dog, sometimes you're the hydrant.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.